In 1967, legendary astrophysicist Jocelyn Bell, then a research student at the University of Cambridge, was studying variations in radio signals using a detector constructed by her advisor and Nobel laureate, Antony Huish. When she noticed sharp, rapid, and regular radio pulses coming from a source in the constellation Vulpecula, several astronomers thought the waves were of extraterrestrial origin. This radio source was therefore called Little Green Men, or LGM for short. Later, they realized that they had in fact stumbled upon a unique type of star, a neutron star. This was the first ever observation of neutron stars. Over the decades, many other kinds of neutron stars were found. But what exactly are neutron stars, and why were they given that name? In 1934, German astronomer Walter Bodd and Swiss astronomer Fritz Zwicky predicted the existence of neutron stars. They proposed that when a dying star explodes as a supernova, the leftover iron core collapses and becomes something new. For this to happen, the mass of the star's core should exceed the Chandrasekhar limit, which has a limit of 1.4 times the mass of the Sun, or around 2.765 times 10 to the 30th kilograms. Once the core collapses, the energy released by the collapse causes the matter around the core to be ejected. Once all of this surrounding matter gets blown away, the only remnant is the core, which goes on to become a neutron star. We have discovered more than 2,500 neutron stars so far. Some well-known examples include the Crab pulsar, located in the Crab Nebula, and the Vela pulsar, found in the Vela supernova remnant. Neutron stars have their name because they are composed primarily of neutrons. There are trace amounts of a similar number of electrons and protons, giving the whole object a net neutral charge. Neutron stars generally have a radius of only around 12 kilometers. With masses exceeding 1.4 times that of the Sun, these are some of the densest objects in the universe. A tablespoonful of neutron star material could weigh as much as Mount Everest. Neutron stars also create one of the most powerful magnetic fields in the universe. Their magnetic fields can be as much as 1 million billion, or 1 quadrillion, times stronger than that of Earth. In fact, in 2004, a neutron star, located around 50,000 light-years away, underwent an outburst. Its magnetic field was so strong that it affected the Earth's ionosphere, even from that monumental distance. In such extreme environments, the matter inside neutron stars likely exhibits properties that are very different from what we usually see. This state of matter is called exotic quark matter, and it could display properties like superconductivity and superfluidity. Neutron stars are classified either as isolated or as members of a binary system. Isolated neutron stars are neutron stars that freely float in space. These neutron stars emit some form of radiation, like visible, infrared, X-ray, or gamma rays. Isolated neutron stars have several subclasses. One such subclass is the compact central objects, found at the center of supernova remnants. Another subclass consists of dim, isolated neutron stars, or DINs, which are relatively older and emit X-rays. The most common subclass, however, are pulsars. Pulsars are rapidly rotating neutron stars that give a periodic pulse or signal. This pulse usually appears as radio emissions, but could in fact be X-rays, optical rays, and gamma rays. While most pulsars spin at roughly once per second, the fastest one ever observed spins around 650 times every second. The pulses we see are emanations of radiation that emerge from a small area on the neutron star's surface. As the neutron star spins, it sweeps this radiation out across space. Whenever the beam gets pointed in the direction of Earth, we see a pulse. This is similar to how a lighthouse functions and has often been called the lighthouse model. Pulsars are one of the most common types of neutron stars that we see. As mentioned, the first neutron star we observed, the one seen by Jocelyn Bell and Antony Huish, was a pulsar. Neutron stars do not have any nuclear fusion process happening at their cores. Since there is no energy production, they eventually cool off and reduce the amount of radiation they emit. They also lose their spin and their magnetic field over time. Neutron stars with a sufficiently close companion star will start accreting matter from the star itself. This would either result in the companion star becoming a white dwarf or a neutron star. However, it could also lead to the destruction of the companion star. there is still a lot left to learn about neutron stars. We have some idea about their properties, which we have learned from pulsars and the gravitational waves emitted by their mergers. However, we still need to get observational evidence on properties like the maximum mass they can have, their radii, and their internal composition. It has helped us discover several things, including novel nuclear processes, new states of matter, and the eventual fate of our stars. Neutron stars, alongside black holes, are some of the most extreme objects in the universe. Studying such objects has helped us unveil new aspects of physics, not only in astronomy, but also in high-energy studies.